This week on Lit, we enter a visual art space as I rap with Garfield Williams, CEO and proprietor and manager and chief artist at the Trenchtown Ceramics and Art Center. Catch me and Garfield Lit live in Trenchtown. Yeah, this is me live in Trenchtown. Check the story, the drama, the history, the mystery, the comedy, the trauma. It's coming to you. Learn about the characters, the people, the personality. Coming to you lit, live in Trenchtown. Check it on YouTube, The Real Blacker. Hey, it's me again, Blacker Ellis, and I'm lit, live in Trenchtown. And today, I'm at the Trenchtown Ceramic and Art Center, a unique space inside of this very interesting place. And I'm having a wonderful sit-down chat with Garfield Williams, the CEO and Managing Director. Brilliant artist, strange man. May I wonder, where am I there? In Trenchtown, with them pottery and creative and art thing. Yeah. So let's talk to Garfield right here, lit, live in Trenchtown.
Yeah, man. Afternoon, Blacker. How you doing, man?
Bless up, my brother. Yeah, so, man, Garfield.
Respect. Yeah, man.
Tell me about yourself.
Yeah, me coming back home, you just mentioned it.
Yeah.
Why am I here? What am I doing here?
Yeah.
I left here in 1972 as a child, going to Victory before it was even called Victory. It was further down Spanish Town Road. Mm-hmm. I left here at the age of 6 years old.
Yeah.
And mom migrated to Ottawa and then from Ottawa to Toronto.
Yeah.
My father was here. They're both from Kingstonian, from Trenchtown. Mm-hmm. My father left Trelawney and my mom left St. Elizabeth Balaclava and merged into Trenchtown.
Yeah.
Here. And then that's how I came about. the mystical place where Bob and the Holy Pub of Father, great artists and great persons come from. But I find myself back here by, being in Balaclava, St. Elizabeth, and I did a whole pottery thing with the schools down there and the youths in the community. And, you know, JBDC found me and said, you have to come to Kingston because the energy where may I push. Yeah. In Balaclava, they saw it more visible and get more support. And them time I not even know where Trenchtown would come from. my mom was in Toronto when I left the country, just to come even look at space and find somewhere for launch a project like this, because I was actually doing something like this in the country with, like I mentioned, schools and the youths in the community. And it worked out that I was over at Farm, Greenwich Farm, just across the road, Spanish Town there.
Yeah.
And, I met a gentleman named Tapazuki.
Are you ready?
Yeah, man, you know Tapa.
Tapazuki.
Yeah, so Tapazuki mentioned to me that, there's a place over here that him actually did start and set up.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a building which he wanted to turn into a studio at the time, but because of the violence and the war that came up in the 80s there, he kind of shifted from the area, and a whole heap of people shifted from the area, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But the building was abandoned for a very, very long time, and I come over here in the community and I met some other potters and man that work with the clay like myself up on the Stinger end, that's a part of Rosestone here. And I got really interested and really involved with the clay, because that was one of the whole reasons for me leaving St. Elizabeth.
Yeah.
The members from JBDC team had mentioned that this clay here in Trenchtown, in Kingston.
Yeah.
They didn't mention Trenchtown, they just mentioned Kingston. So Mr. I have to reach.
Yeah.
And I've been back and forth into Kingston because for many years since I returned home in 97 with my mother, we're actually importing clay, white clay.
Yeah.
And the white clay wasn't authentic enough.
No.
It didn't give the whole vibes or the vibration of authenticity of Jamaican products.
Like earth.
Cool, yeah. Naman. So, hearing that from the JBDC team, that kind of pushed me more to come to Kingston. And when I did arrive to Kingston and being over the farm and introduced over to this side, I then saw the whole transformation, the whole process. The Prince's Foundation had just come into the community.
Yeah.
I met a gentleman named Earl Jackson, and Earl Jackson introduced me to the whole project with the members them that came down, and also the members of the Potters Association.
In Rosetown.
And from then, the journey started.
Yeah.
And tell it's been a mystical
one. I think I'm hearing something. I'm hearing that the environment, the space called Trenchtown, spoke to you and said, here's the place.
Mystically, it did talk to me, because before my mother returned from Toronto, I'm walking around this place. Yeah. But every venue, every corner shop, every food shop, because it was a vibes for me to be in a place like this.
Yeah.
Because growing up in Toronto, I had locks on my head.
Yeah.
And it was all because of Bob.
Yeah.
And only my friends from Toronto could come here and tell you that I grew my hair to my shoulders.
Yeah.
And it was just the love of Bob Marley. We sat, we went to beaches, we went camping, and Bob was always in the energy.
Yeah.
And it, just coming here and being here and walking around the place, from as far as Black Rose's Corner to over Jonestown, I'm walking the whole place, and I just felt like I was from here.
And you're safe.
The place, the vibes, the energy.
Yeah.
It was like, some people laugh when they tell them this. At that time.
They think you're a crazy man.
Party was in this place. Parties were in this place every night.
Yeah.
My first experience was the Bob Marley birthday festival that was down at Vin Lawrence Park. Yeah. And trust me, this was like Hollywood in Jamaica.
Yeah.
Trenchtown. That's how I looked at the place.
Jamaica, Hollywood, indeed.
Martella, and the funny thing is that I felt like I was from here.
Yeah.
I felt like I was a part of here without even my mother calling me and asking me, where am I? Where are you, son?
People tend to focus on who come from Trenchtown. Bob Marley sang, "We come from Trenchtown," but Bob Marley came to Trenchtown, like you did. And in awareness, this place pull spirits, pull the right spirits. Some wrong ones too, but we pull the right spirits to make this place.
There's a lot of good in this community.
So here we are, the Trenchtown Ceramics and Art Center, run by Garfield. And it's just up the road from where me born and grow, at Upper First Street. It's a wonderful place, full of amazing artwork. Garfield, tell us about the place, and who do I work with you?
Yeah, man.
What are we? What are going on now?
We're on Black. Our location here is 38-40 Upper First Street.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, 1st and 7th. We're right behind the Polytechnical College there that just evolved. The Trenchtown High School is. I'm familiar with that from I came into the area.
Comprehensive High School, let us know.
Yes.
The Polytechnic College.
We did quite a few things with the art teachers, the students there, and it was a very nice vibes, having the students come in. And also Charlie. Charlie's one of the schools that we also have that's from the community that's here. And there's quite a few schools that come into the center here.
How their staff?
The guys that's around me here is Marland over there painting that candle holder.
Bless Marlon.
Yeah, man. We have Brammy, Abraham Grant.
Brammy himself.
Yeah. He's a icon, a fossil in this whole.
Yeah, man. Veteran in Trenchtown.
Yeah, man. Veteran in Trenchtown. And also a veteran in the clay.
Yes.
Because he used to be a part of the Things Jamaica team.
Ah.
Yeah, man. That used to
back in the days.
Be out in the horizon there, where Horizon is now.
Yeah.
And then we have AKA Shop Boss as Lester.
Yeah.
Over there sanding the pieces right there. Yeah, man.
And what happens here on a regular, when things are active and up, what would have been happening here?
On a regular day, we just perform tasks where we try, to add to production, add to the volume of the pieces that you see around the shop here.
Yeah.
To, at one time, at one time before the COVID and the epidemic, it was really busy, and we had, things going out, orders coming in. But since the COVID, things have slowed down. Away from the energy of what you see going on in here, we have outreach programs, which we have youths come in, We
kids treat.
Yes, we keep treats. We've had in the past all kinds of sponsors like the European Union, the Marley Foundation, TPDCO, SDC. We have many of persons that come on board and given us a strength. Recently, we've had the German embassy that we're going to be featuring a workshop with the kids. And that's basically one of the things me feel that's my purpose for being home and being back in my community, is to, you know, make the wider the diasporas and the people, the persons that here in Jamaica know that, you know.
The way I see it, I see Garfield as a man on a mission. It's not just a door thing, it's a man on a mission. Because what he's doing here could have been done anywhere else.
Oh, yeah,
but he's chosen to do it here and do it with the people here. So it's like, this for me is what is the essence of LIT, life in Trenchtown. He's showing you a different way of life in Trenchtown. Yeah, man. So Garfield, I want you to look in the camera and tell the people then. Tell your clients. Tell the market. Tell the world why they must come here.
Trenchtown. Trenchtown is a mystical, beautiful place. And the people, you know, the people themselves, they're you know, there's something to, or ones to actually reason and talk to and feel that vibration that Bob sung about. There's not much more to really say, but you have to come. You have to visit this place, this mystical and magical place.
And I want to tell people, if you want to plan a birthday party, a nice theme birthday party, do it here. You can. We have a nice outdoor setting. There's food, there's vibe, there's the kitchen, there's artwork. You can have nice loot bags with artwork. Have your birthday party right there. I promise you, it's going to be amazing. And it's going to be extremely lit, because it's live in Trenchtown. Yeah.
Hi, my name is Garfield Williams, and we're from the Trenchtown Ceramics and Arts Center, and we're lit live in Trenchtown.